Good Saturday afternoon, Young Leland Dinner in Washington, D.C. In for Eric Shawn these hours. Brand new hour, very busy hour of America's News Headquarters. Raquel, nice to see you.
Good to be with you, Leland, and hello every one of our fellow devil in New York. Stopping the news this hour, a week after the violence in Charlottesville, thousands of people took to the streets of Boston for dueling rallies, a sign that unrest continues across the country.
Another major staff shakeup at the White House. The president's controversial chief strategist, Steve Bannon, becomes the latest member of the Trump inner circle to depart.
And authorities in Spain intensifying their manhunt for the driver who plowed a van into a crowd of pedestrians. America's News Headquarters starts right now.
Thousands flooded the streets in Boston. Protesters, counter-protesters. But now things are calming down a little bit. Many of the counter-protesters opposing what was described as a free speech rally held by conservatives. That ended early. Today's mostly peaceful events come just 1 week after the deadly violence in Charlottesville, Virginia. Some of those counter-protesters are still in the streets. Some of them, shall we say, having some terse words with the police there. We have Fox Team coverage. Steve Harrigan live from Roxbury Community College covering the counter-protest, a much larger group. But we've been with Molly Line live from Boston Commons. So we had this right-leaning free speech rally planned, Molly.
Arrested overall, most of those for disorderly conduct, a few assaults, some urine involved from the police. Police officials talking about the protesters, the counter-protesters, and a much smaller group of troublemakers. Some of those troublemakers wearing bulletproof vests and arrested as well. The goal here was to keep the two sides apart. The mayor said he did not want another Charlottesville here, and largely he succeeded with his officers in that effort today. Marcel, back to you.
A job well done by the Boston Police, no doubt. Two very things for the election to get new, and now he's going on politics.
Yeah, a lot on politics. The president comes back from his two-week summer vacation this weekend, and when he arrives at the White House, there will be one less senior staffer there. The president now thanking Steve Bannon for his time as chief strategist just one day after his official departure. Rich Edson live from Bridgewater, New Jersey, near the president's golf club. Hi, Rich.
Hey, Lee Lincoln, and you're the president, fairly active on Twitter today here from Central Jersey. In Bedminster, New Jersey. He's tweeting about Boston, about the protests ongoing there. Said the president complimented the Boston Police Department, the mayor of Boston. And also he said, quote, our country has been divided for decades. Sometimes you need to protest in order to heal, and we will heal and be stronger than ever before. He also applauded the protesters speaking out against bigotry and hate. Harder from television.
Bigotry, that's you, Mr. Trump. That.
Service, only a few hours after the White House announced his departure, Bannon is now trying to influence the Trump White House from the outside at Breitbart, where he says he plans to go to war for this president. Earlier this week, Bannon warned of an economic war with China, criticized the administration's strategy in North Korea and Asia, warning he wanted to push officials at the State Department out and get the hawks in. Internal foreign policy deliberations continue without Steve Bannon. The president yesterday convened his national security team at Camp David. They were discussing strategy in Afghanistan. President Steve on that also today from Bedminster.
Sports cover.
Camp David with our very talented generals and military leaders. Many decisions made, including on Afghanistan. Now, the White House has yet to offer specifics. The White House has yet to offer a timeline as to when we might hear from the president or officials on what exactly the Afghanistan strategy will be, whether there will be an increase in troops, whether contractors will play a greater role in supplying American military personnel. The White House will only say that we'll hear about all that when the time is appropriate. Especially more of the Steve Bannon shake throughout the show. Rich, thank you.
Yeah, we will take you abroad now, where the intense manhunt continues in Spain for the driver of the van that plowed into a crowd in Barcelona that attacked Thursday, killing 13 people and injured about 120 others. A few hours later, another vehicle attacked, killing one person and injured five others in the town of Cambos. Meanwhile, police in Spain also searching for an imam believed to have radicalized a group of men behind these attacks. Benjamin Hall is live in Barcelona with the latest on this investigation. Benjamin, just after midnight there, what's the feeling like on the ground?
Yeah, good evening, Al. I mean, look, the last couple of days we've reached out for the briefing. Up and down this boulevard, being flowers, lighting candles. But today we saw a change. We saw a real increase in security. And that is because the man now is no longer over. They thought they had arrested and killed the man who drove that white van down this boulevard on Thursday. That's not the case. They say he is still at large. And now they've released a picture of him. His name, they say, is Yunus Abu Yaqub. He's 22 years old, he's a Moroccan, and they feel that he is the main director behind this attack. So very much the manhunt is still on over here. The Abu Yaqub came from a very small village about an hour outside Barcelona. And this town is now the front city for him now.
Still on the run, but you know they're looking for Yaqub. What's the latest though on the manhunt? Any further details of that story?
I mean, initially, you know, they've got road blocks around Barcelona, they were looking for him around here, but we now know that they have extended that, and there is a fear at the moment that he may have crossed into France, so border security is really being hyped up there. We know that one of the other terrorists rented a car, a Renault, they're desperately looking for that, and if indeed he has managed to escape to France, then that means this is a Europe-wide manhunt, and that's a real fear here, it means that people will not be able to get back to their normal lives. And of course, we have to keep remembering the victims here. 13 who died here, one who died in Kabul in that other attack. Among them, a 74-year-old lady, a 3-year-old boy, people from Italy, France, many countries around the world, and of course that American, Jared Tucker, who's 42 years old from California. He came here to celebrate his first wedding anniversary with his wife. His father was speaking out earlier. He said that the only excuse you have is that maybe his son died happy at least. But it's just terrible. You put it on the street, say, you see people gathering around, you see inside the house down for the green. The driver of the white van who plowed down this road on Thursday is caught. The feeling is the city won't be able to get back to normal at all.